We want to determine the domain of the function f of x equals the square root of the quantity x minus 2 divided by the quantity x minus 5. For this function, both the numerator and denominator will give us restrictions on the domain. Let's start by considering the denominator. We know division by 0 is undefined, so any x value that makes the denominator equal to 0 must be excluded. So to show this, let's set x minus 5 equal to 0. If we solve this, we can see x equals 5 would make the denominator equal to 0, and therefore we must exclude this value because that's when we'd have division by 0. So x cannot equal 5 is one restriction on the domain. Now let's consider the numerator. In order for the numerator to be a real number, the number underneath the square root cannot be negative, meaning it must be greater than or equal to 0. So the next restriction is x minus 2 must be greater than or equal to 0, again, in order for the numerator to be a real number. So if we solve this for x, we have x is greater than or equal to positive 2. This is the second restriction on our domain. So there are several ways to express the domain. One way would be to say the domain is when x is greater than or equal to positive 2 and x does not equal 5. But let's also graph this domain. So we'll start by labeling our number line. Let's start with, to exclude 5 from the domain, we'll make an open point on the number line at positive 5. And then we'll graph the inequality x is greater than or equal to positive 2, keeping in mind x can't equal 5. So we'd have a closed point on positive 2, and then an arrow to the right. But because we have to exclude 5, we would draw an arrow from here to the open circle on 5, and then continue it to the right of positive 5. This would be the graph of the domain of the function. Let's also list the domain of the function using interval notation. To help us do this, we know as we continue right, we're going to approach positive infinity. So we have two intervals here. We have the interval from 2 to 5, where the interval is closed on 2 and open on 5. So we'd have a square bracket on 2 and a parenthesis on positive 5, union. And then we have the interval from 5 to infinity, open on 5. So a parenthesis, 5, comma, infinity. So we've given the domain three different ways. We've expressed it using inequalities, we've expressed it using interval notation, and we've expressed it graphically. As a last check for the domain, it's often helpful to graph the function and project the function onto the x-axis. So here's the graph of our function. If we were to project this down onto the x-axis, or you could think of it as making a shadow on the x-axis, notice how the graph starts at positive 2. There's a break at positive 5, but it is continuous between 2 and 5, and then to the right of positive 5, it's continuous. Verifying our domain is correct. I hope you found this helpful.